Good morning, and welcome to Monday's Thoughts for the Day. As you can see, I'm not Reverend Stephen, and I'm certainly not Sister Myrtle. That's because both Myrtle and Stephen have kindly asked me to share today's Thoughts for the Day with you, because on Saturday, I was received into full connection within the Methodist Church. You may be watching this and wondering, what does it mean to be received into full connection? Well, the Methodist Church Conference receives into full connection with itself those who are called to exercise an ordained ministry specifically through the Methodist Church. When they are received into full connection, ministers, both presbyters and deacons, enter a covenant relationship with the conference. At the heart of this mutual relationship, made possible through God's grace, both the ministers and the conference have appropriate privileges and responsibilities. After reception into full connection, ordinands go to their venues to be ordained. I was going to be received into full connection at Telford and ordained in Wellington. And at first I was sad not to be received into full connection and be ordained physically. I was sad not to be standing with my good friends who I've candidated and trained with over the years. Instead, we was received into full connection on Zoom. But let's be honest, so many people have lost a loved one or had to cancel so many things, so why should we, the Methodist Church, be any different? But I want to thank the Methodist Church for making it a meaningful service, because people was able to join me who maybe couldn't travel to Wellington but was able to watch live on the internet. The president said the following to us: "Sisters and brothers, we are ready to admit you into the full connection with this conference. Do you accept these obligations, and do you confirm that you believe and will preach our doctrines, and that you will faithfully observe and administer our discipline as determined by the conference?" I was able to say, "I do," with pride. I had tears when hearing, "We receive you into full connection." Tears of joy. Tears because of all the work and all those essays that have been done. But tears because I am truly humbled to minister to wonderful people. How many people can say that they were received into full connection from their manse, with colleagues and friends from all locations across the nations watching? Saturday was the engagement party, and the ordination is the wedding. I have met some wonderful friends on this journey, and it was great celebrating with them virtually on Saturday. And when I have a date for my ordination, I will certainly let you know. At conference, we may disagree on certain business items, but we come together and agree on is it celebration of ordinations, because we are a connection. It's a time also when ministers remember their ordination. Back in the Nid Valley circuit, I was able to know some wonderful supernumerary ministers. The Reverend Colin Lake, who this weekend has celebrated 60 years of ministry. And I've worked with wonderful ministers like Reverend Brian Hoare. Both of these ministers happen to be ministers in Hull, but I met them in Harrogate and Knaresborough, because Methodism is certainly a small world, but we are a connection. And we remember not just our own ordinations, but we remember all of those the past ordinations. It's an opportunity to remember ministers who have died over the years. But what does connection mean? I want to suggest that we look at 1 Corinthians 12.
1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 12 to 27. Just as a body, though one, has many parts, but all its many parts form one body, so it is with Christ. For we were all baptized by one Spirit, so as to form one body, whether Jews or Gentiles, slave or free, and we were all given the one Spirit to drink. And so the body is not made up of one part, but of many. Now if the foot should say, because I am not a hand, I do not belong to the body, it would not for that reason cease to be part of the body. And if the ear should say, because I am not an eye, I do not belong to the body, it would not for that reason cease to be part of the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would the sense of hearing be? If the whole body were an ear, where would the sense of smell be? But in fact, God has placed the parts in the body, every one of them, just as he wanted them to be. If they're all one part, where would the body be? As it is, there are many parts, but one body. The eye cannot say to the hand, I don't need you. And the head cannot say to the feet, I don't need you. On the contrary, those parts of the body that seem to be weaker are dispensable, and the parts that we think are less honourable we treat with special honour. And the parts that are unpresentable are treated with special modesty. While our presentable parts need no special treatment, but God has put the body together, giving greater honour to the parts that lacked it, so that there should be no division in the body, but that its parts should have equal concern for each other. If one part suffers, every part suffers with it. If one part is honoured, every part rejoices with it. Now you are the body of Christ, and each one of you is part of it. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The reading that we've just heard is a well-known reading by Paul as he's talking to a church that is living in division, and he talks about the importance of unity as the body of Christ. And what does our founder John Wesley say about the body of Christ? He talks a lot about connection. And this is what John Wesley says. Do not allow yourself one thought of separating from your brothers and sisters, whether their opinions agree with yours or not. John Wesley also says that the gospel of Christ knows no religion but social, no holiness but social holiness. Wesley is basically saying that you can be holier than thou. You can know everything about scripture from front to back. You can go to church every Sunday faithfully, but you need each other as the body of Christ. Social holiness. As a circuit, we are connected to each other. Different cultures and traditions coming together and learning from each other. This is needed in the world today, and we can be the ones who show the world how to learn from all culture and tradition. I want to thank the New River Circuit for welcoming me and Helen with open arms and allowing me to grow during my probation period. Thank you to the churches I minister, Holly Park, Middle Lane and Muswell Hill, and for all the messages of support I have received the last couple of months. I am truly blessed to have supportive colleagues, Reverend Stephen, Sister Myrtle, Reverend Robert, Reverend Rupert, and Reverend Sam. It's been great learning from their all their experience. I've valued their knowledge, and I'm sure that they've valued me because maybe I've brought the age down a bit in staff meeting. But I have learnt so much from the circuit staff. As circuit staff and as a circuit, we are connected as the body of Christ. And I pray that this will be the circuit, the New River Circuit will be the circuit that shows the rest of the connection around Methodism of what celebrating diversity really means. I pray that this will be the circuit where lay ministry is celebrated and we are truly blessed to keep having people called to local preaching. And one of those preachers is as young as 16 years old. But we will be the ones that dream big, and we will be the ones where people are called to exercise their ministry in a variety of ways, and that the connection will realize the good work that we are doing in this circuit, because we are part of the one body. This can also be the circuit that can live with different opinions, where we read maybe the Bible differently, but whatever our opinions is, that we respect each other, because we are part of the body of Christ. The reading that we've heard says that actually we can live in unity. So let's not be like the church in Corinth, where they're not living in unity, but let's be the church in this circuit that lives in unity, where hope is alive, where love is found. I would like to also thank my family and friends for joining me and for all over the UK on Saturday, especially in Hull, Harrogate and London. Helen and I have met some wonderful people, and you have made this journey special. So thank you. Helen and I have not seen some of our family members since November, but we are connected thanks to Zoom. Finally, my final thanks goes to Helen, who is my rock. Helen has supported me throughout this journey. She's moved with me to Harrogate and now London. Helen has moved jobs and has given so much up so that she can move with me. We are a team and we are doing this together. Marriage is a connection and should always be celebrated in the Methodist Church. Helen and I do ministry together. Friends, I celebrate that we are all part of the body of Christ. So may diversity and unity be celebrated in this circuit. Let us pray. Risen Christ, we recognize that all good things come from you. You give us this day, a day of celebration, a day of commitment, a day to uphold one another in love. We recognize it also as a day of sadness. We gather in unexpected ways and not as we had hoped. We pray for the ordinands. We rejoice that today they will be received into full connection, and we wait with them for the time of their ordination. We pray for those we receive into full connection with the conference. We thank you for the journey that each has travelled to this point and rejoice with them. And we commit ourselves to journey with those who must now wait for the time of their ordination. In rejoicing and waiting, surround them with your love and protection, we pray. We pray for each person participating in this act of worship wherever they are. At this difficult time for the world, we hold before you all our emotions. Sadness for what and who we have lost. Thankfulness for what we have gained. Forgive us when we fail to put our trust in you. Strengthen us when we struggle to see you at work. Be with us now and in the days to come, until the time comes when we can physically gather again. In your name. Amen. And that was a prayer said on Saturday to all the ordinands. For my testimony service, I was hoping that Joel was going to play a song at my testimony service at Wesley Chapel, and the song is 10,000 Reasons by Matt Redman. And I picked this song because people may say, why have you become a minister? And I can say, I have 10,000 reasons why. So let us continue to worship together as we show unity.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name. Your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, worship your holy name. Bless you, Lord. and draws near, and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then His holy name, sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. Come, bless the Lord, oh, my soul. Oh, my soul, worship His holy name. Worship your holy name, Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never. Your holy name, worship your holy name.